Hey guys, cheers, doing some barbecue here. Cin cin ragazzi. So, I have 3 minutes of time until I burn everything. And I had a lot of questions about, this will be a very small video, a lot of questions about what for me is important to be consistent and precise with the frameless, but with the slish is the same. For me, the important thing is the release. Release 100% for me is the most important. Your hand, let your hand move around. We are no robot, so it will always move around, same as archery, same with a rifle and everything. In the last moment, with a surprise shot and everything, your brain will make the final correction and with the front end. But the release has to be smooth, not forced, and also you don't have, like in archery, when you go transfer to hold in the back, tension and everything, you don't have to creep. So keep pulling, even if it's just a fraction weight of with a bow, with a slingshot, it's just a fraction of the weight or something, but doesn't matter. If you do this, or one time you do that or something, it won't be good. So you will be okay maybe in the short distance, but you will be shooting maybe 25 meters, 30 meters or something, you will see the little creep. It will make a long way over there. So, like in archery, always keep pulling, and same here. If you go like this, you keep pulling, and when you reach your trigger, your right position, just let it go, and your hand will go to the back. And for me, this is what I think. And also, they asked me about the pouch. I already made a video. I don't use I use a pinch grip now, pinch ball grip, for a while now, and I love it because I just grab the steel ball, my index. I go inside like this. I go inside. You grab the ball, and you are ready to shoot. So you grab your ball, you go inside, you pull like this, and you are ready to shoot. So it's very fast, and when you get used to it, it's very precise. So the most important thing is the dimension of the ball with the dimension of the pouch. The ball doesn't have to be too small or crazy too big, because otherwise you won't be you won't have a smooth release. Also, the ball, you don't have to squeeze the ball, just hold the ball in your fingers, with your skin, and then just let it go smoothly. Okay, so let's make a few shots, and let's see if we can show you the release. Close like this. There you go. Just don't worry about the hand in the front. Don't worry about the hand in the front. Just think about your release. Work on your release, on your form, and you will be good. So go back like this. Even if you have a fixed anchor point or a full butterfly, well, full butterfly is kind of hard, but you can move in the last moment with the back tension, and or semi butterfly like this, like I do. I don't stay fixed like this. I just stay like this, I keep pulling, and when I just let it go. And also, if you see the great Chinese shooters, now I forgot the name of the most famous one, they can shoot also two balls at the same time, the most famous Chinese shooter. If you see his videos on Rallenty, you will see that he pulls and he never stops. He keeps pulling, and after release. So this is the good way to do it. Have fun, good luck, and cheers.